vision of DSIRDA and how it is different from other smart cities of India?
See, after independence, India has not created many new greenfield cities. We have created some 4 or 5 cities. These are mainly political capitals. But there are obvious advantages of urbanization, because it's much easier for government to provide all the services, quality services to all its residents. And people move to urban areas in search of better opportunities in education, health, employment. If they are innovative, they can get a bigger market for all these ideas, better institutions. So people have always been moving to urban areas in search of better opportunities. But now our cities are so clogged that we are losing most of the advantages of urbanization. Now productivity in cities is going down because of obvious reasons, pollution, traffic jams, too much of crowding of places. There are hardly any public places now which can be used by all sections of society. So there is an urgent need to create greenfield cities. So Dholera is being developed with a vision to create a city which will be the most livable city in India, and this can also become a role model for future development in India, new cities in India.
Okay, that is great. So, sir, what are the major projects currently operational in
Dholera
Smart City?
Okay, so there are 8 projects undergoing in Dholera. One is roads and services, that is a comprehensive package, it includes all the services. Then we are going for other projects like water treatment plant, CETP, Adhya River Bonding, ICT, and there are some minor projects also. We are spending a lot of money on beautification, so there are 2 projects on river beautification project that we are spending close to 45 crore rupees on that. So all these projects are likely to be completed by mid-2020. So roughly 80% of work has already been carried out in the area. Now Dholera is ready for businesses, and we have already started getting some industries to start their operations.
And so Dholera is also an industrial city. So what are the industry sectors and companies which are hosted at Dholera's industrial city?
Right now, Tata Chemicals Limited has already purchased 125 acres of land in Dholera. And they'll be setting up a lithium ion battery plant for electric vehicles and power storage solutions. In fact, this is very much in line with our overall goal to attract new age industries and create sustainable model for transport. So we are very glad that Tata is setting up a lithium ion battery plant in Dholera. We are also the most sustainable city in India. We are very much concerned about climate change and other things, and how to reduce the impact on climate change, how to reduce the carbon footprint. So Dholera is designed in a way to reduce the carbon footprint. That way we are also the most sustainable city.
Alright, great, sir. Sir, what are the major stakeholders in these projects?
I think the biggest stakeholders are, I would say, the local people, because this is a very unique project. We are not going for land acquisition. Okay. Generally, what happens in land acquisition, once land is acquired, people get a lot of money, but they don't know how to make good use of that money. So after some time, they spend all the money in buying bungalows or cars, and only very small percentage of people are in a position to make good use of that money. So in the long term, it has been observed that their lifestyle has gone down. So this is a very different kind of project where we are going for town planning schemes in which all the landowners become the stakeholders in this project. So we are implementing town planning scheme. They will get 50% of fully developed plot. So that way local people become stakeholders in this project, and then they are free to use their land in their own way. They can set up their industries or commercial places, residential units, and they can also lease out to other companies or sell the land in future when they will get a very good appreciation. That is very important factor. Then the government has set up one special purpose vehicle.
Okay.
So government of Gujarat is having 51% stake in that. And government of India through DMICDC is having 49% stake. So that way both the governments are cooperating to create this green city. We have very good partners like L&T is our main contractor. They are having 3 contracts, roads and services, CET, PR, STP. And we have other reputed companies who are implementing the projects. Ecom is our PMNC. So they are also great asset to this company.
That is good, sir. And I think one of the maybe people be awaiting this answer ki, we have planned an international airport over there. So can you just brief about that?
Ahmedabad's existing airport is already facing constraints due to non-availability of land in the area, and its taxiway is also not covering full runway. So there are constraints on the air side also. Now Ahmedabad needs second airport, so Dholera is going to be the second airport for Ahmedabad. So that way Airport Authority of India has taken majority stake in the Dholera International Airport Company Limited, and soon we are going to start the work on that airport, and that will also give a lot of boost to this whole SIR region. And also we are thinking of creating MRO facility, so Dholera can become a major hub for aviation sector. We are also in the process of inviting defense manufacturing companies, including for Air Force and other services. So Dholera Airport can act as a testing ground, and that runway can be used for MRO facility and for testing of other fighter jets and all.
Wow, that is really great. Sir, what is the role of technology like artificial intelligence and blockchain in this and in the execution of all these projects going on?
We have floated RFP, that is the most comprehensive RFP in the ICT segment in this country. So a lot of the smart cities are coming up with very innovative kind of projects. Some are going for traffic management using technology, some are going for SCADA. But our ICT is the most comprehensive. It includes all the 8 verticals that have been identified by our consultant. So this will again become a role model for future cities in India. And now everything is being guided by ICT. So we'll get the information, use artificial intelligence, use machine learning, analyze all the information, and we'll make this information available to our industries, to our residents, and also for administrative purposes. So idea is to make industries more competitive, make our people more productive, and use this information by administration to deal with any kind of emergency, to support people in their day-to-day lives, and to tackle any kind of emergency.
So, sir, with that comes the question of the data security, yes, with these advanced technology and the abundance of data. So, what do you think, how do you ensure the safety of that data security?
In fact, our tender includes a 2-year implementation period and 5-year maintenance by the same contractor. So, and we have taken all the care to include all the security features in the tender itself.
Okay, that is great. Sir, do we have any foreign collaboration with our projects?
In fact, Ecom is one of the most renowned engineering consultancy firm in the world. So, they are our main consultants. And at the design stage itself, we have utilized the services of the best in the world. So like Cisco was involved in the design of ICT. Many more companies have been engaged by DigDil and DMICDC to bring best practices in Dholera.
Okay. And it is very developing right now in Dholera. It also compromises with the environment when the urban development comes and when the industrial hub it is in making. So it compromises the environment. So how DSIRDA ensures the eco-friendly schemes here?
Now climate change has become a major concern, and especially country like India will be worst affected because climate change is likely to impact our monsoon system. So India should be very careful about, you know, impact of climate change, and therefore we are making Dholera a truly sustainable city. Now I have read that many countries are going for communities where they'll, you know, like Australia is coming up with a plan to create communities where people will not be required to use vehicles to go to their workplace. They will provide all the amenities like health facilities, education facilities in the vicinity. But even 5 years back when Dholera plan was being finalized, we have taken care of all these things. So within walking distance, we are providing for all these facilities like community parks, health facilities, educational facilities, and we are promoting this walk-to-work culture. So that way, we are very much conscious about, you know, these environmental aspects, and this is also going to be more egalitarian society because we are creating facilities, community facilities, which will be accessible to each and every resident in the city. And they'll be able to enjoy a good quality of life.
That is really great, sir. Sir, any upcoming plans right now for
PSIIT? Right now, we are actively looking for many more companies to set up their operations. We have proposed some new projects in the area, like we are proposing firing range for defense. Production units, they will be able to do the testing in Dholera. So that will help us attract defense related industries in Dholera. We are also coming up with 5000 megawatt solar power. GUVNL has already done the bidding, and Tata Power Limited and GIPCL are going to set up solar park in that area very soon. For remaining capacity, SECI will also chip in, and they are going to do the bidding. And that process will also start very soon. NHAI has already floated the tender, and soon they are likely to finalize the tender and work on expressway between Ahmedabad and Dholera will start. So that will also again give a huge boost to our efforts to bring it closer to Ahmedabad and attract many more industries. Lot many companies and associations have recently visited Dholera. They are really amazed with the kind of development that is happening in that area. And soon we'll be able to bring many more industries to set up their operations in Dholera.
Sir, thank you so much. Just last, any message or information you would like to share with our viewers?
I think even if I'm appealing to all the people that even if you are not an investor in Dholera, you don't have any, you know, opportunity to set up your businesses. I think you must visit this place because the kind of infrastructure that is being created, we are creating the most sustainable city. This is going to be the role model for future cities in India. And in fact, many cities can get many more ideas how to make your city sustainable, more egalitarian, more environmental friendly. So these are the best practices. This should be replicated in many more cities in India.
Thank you so much for your time, sir. Thank you.
So much.